Thorium energy is a form of fission energy. It means that you take one of the heavy elements, in this case thorium, in the periodic table, and you bombard that with one neutron, and then you make it split into two smaller, lighter elements. And then when you do that, you extract a lot of energy. And actually, when you do that, you extract a million times more energy per kilogram than what you can get out of burning oil or gasoline or stuff like that. So it's a very dense energy form. And what you do to get a thorium reaction going, where you can extract lots of energy and turn it into electricity, it's a little bit more complicated. You need to build a system, but first you need to get the thorium out of the ground. Thorium is a metal, so it's taken out of the ground and handled in similar ways as when you take iron or some other steel products out of the ground and refine them in refineries and make them into a product. You do the same with thorium, and then you put it into a reactor. But then thorium cannot start the reaction by itself. You need something called a kickstarter fuel. And I cannot go into the details of explaining that, but in general, you can use something called uranium-235, or you can use plutonium-239. That are two of the isotopes that exist in this world that you can use to start the process of converting thorium into energy. Then once you get this process starting, what is happening is that every time you split a thorium atom, you get three or two, it depends, it's statistic, but you get two or three extra neutrons. And these extra neutrons are then used to split the next thorium elements, and then again, they will release more neutrons. So you get this chain reaction going where you, all the time you release more and more neutrons, and these neutrons are then used to split new atoms. And each atom only releases a tiny amount of energy, but you know that there are billions many billion atoms in each gram of thorium. So when you split many of these, it happens on an atomic scale. So it's really small, but when you add it up, it produces a lot of energy, a lot more energy than what you can get from burning fossil fuels or gas or something like that. And then you keep the energy is basically returned as heat. So you heat up the surroundings. And in this case, it's a molten salt. The best way to make this process run is when you add the thorium into a molten salt. It's a little bit like table salt that you heat up to a temperature between 600 and 800 degrees Celsius. And then inside there, the thorium atoms are sitting and they split and they produce energy. And then this salt warms up. So you have this very hot salt. And then you convert the heat from that hot salt into some other thing. For example, you can boil water and make steam, and the steam can drive a turbine, and the turbine can drive an electric generator, and that produces electricity. But you can also use the heat directly to, for example, you can convert biomass, that is waste from producing wooden tables and chairs and stuff like that. There's a lot of waste material from that, and there's also a lot of waste material from producing corn and other things like that in the and you can take those waste products, and then you can use that heat to convert that into oil. So you can actually produce oil and gasoline and other types of fuels that you would need to power cars and airplanes directly from the heat that you get out of thorium energy. So that's basically how thorium energy works.